What's up, y'all? Welcome back to Zachary X. How are y'all doing today? So, in front of me, we got Infinity Train, Season 4, Episodes 5 and 6. We got... Sorry, I forgot the name of the episode for a second. The Astro Q car. It's a very unfamiliar phrase. And then the party car right after this. So, in the last episode, we went to the Old West, found out Kes is apparently an outlaw. There's a lot of people mad at her. Also, that damn cat showed up again. That damn cat. I swear, that cat's always fucking with somebody. Cats, what's with cats and being evil? Why y'all gotta do this? Like, that cat's curiosity almost got them killed. Damn. And then also in the episode after that, we ended up in the pig baby car, and the pig baby just wanted something good to eat, but then they weren't gonna be able to stop feeding it, which was really messed up. Like, you can't trick me to just stay here. Like, no, that's bullshit. I'm not about to stay here. Shoot. You're gonna stay here and keep cooking for pig baby till he dies. Then you become pig baby. It's like, okay, it seems clearer that you are the one controlling this car than the pig baby is. Like, that's really messed up. Goddamn. Like, I hope you fall off of that somehow and smash against something, you porcelain. But also, in the last episode, when the numbers actually did drop up again for once, Mingy essentially said that they went down because we're here to learn lessons, and that Ryan was the one meant to be on the train, not him. And it's like, dude, are you serious? Like, I'm sorry, you just, shit, not even throw him under the bus. You threw him under the train. Like, dude, like, you say you forgive him for getting y'all onto this train, but also, like, you got on here too. You also have the same number. Your numbers are synced up together. The numbers went back up because you said some dumb shit, because you seem to think that you're not supposed to be here and you have nothing to learn. You know, if that ain't the epitome of this show, man. I mean, Mickey's gonna get his lesson. Ryan, I can't help but think that that may have set him back a little bit as well, which, I honestly want these two to just get along and get better. I love it. Again, I ship it. But also, like, I just, that's real messed up, man. It's real messed up. Also, Kes is causing all kinds of trouble throughout these cars and almost getting them killed multiple times. Like, damn, girl, really? And clearly you have a problem with them actually getting better. So are you going to try and sabotage them? Is that what I feel like is going to happen? Mm-mm. It's real messed up. Real messed up. But we're going to get back into this. Here we go.
You got this, buddy. I believe in you.
Can't... No. Also, where did that come from?
Hey now, each little step can help Ryan learn.
I'm just trying my best.
All right, let's not check our number yet. We don't want to get discouraged.
Don't want to ruin this fun time we've been having.
You guys don't seem to be having fun.
No.
Smug.
Yes.
And annoyed?
Yeah, their roles kind of switched.
Aimless and hungry.
I'm a woman of many sensations.
Okay, I'll give you that one. Hey. Whoa, Mars? Robots? What is...
Oh, yeah. My friends are in there. So is the exit.
You're...
Kes has a very liberal definition of the word friends.
So that is a fair point.
Any hints on things we can do to apply the lessons we learned while almost being forcibly turned into piglets?
Nah. Nah.
Point? Is it crazy? Is it loud?
Yeah. I don't go to, like, nerd parties.
I'm ready for this! I'm so ready! I know you think you're ready, but there's a reason.
Listen to me. We got this.
Yes. You know, this is the only time I'll agree with Kes right now.
She's a bell. Why was that warm?
This is just getting into a club. That's pretty much what I do every day.
That is not wrong. Why you got a chain around your neck, bro?
Tough night, huh?
All
these hosers lining up for a taste of the nightlife.
Nah, son.
Should I even be surprised?
What the?
What the? Why? What the? What? What?
Ugh, do your corpse bodies do that too?
No.
New plan.
Yeah. Look, even I don't got the patience for this long ass line. Shit.
I think maybe this isn't the best plan.
Well, dude. If it's my emotional growth, then let me sort it out.
Nah.
Gave it your best, and that's all anyone can ask.
But stop being condescending, man. Jeez.
If we can't go over, let's go under.
I don't think we have. Underneath. Well,
that should probably give me big muscles, right?
Technically, no. Also, there's craters everywhere, man. God, all those bells ringing jokes.
Deal with it.
Yeah, I kind of don't blame in this instance. Whoa, you made a lot of progress. Well, actually, I think you could just go straight now. Oh, no.
Yo, Min, Mingi, little help?
I already helped. With my advice, maybe now's a good time to be thinking it over.
Maybe you should open your damn eyes and stop being an ass for 5 seconds.
Like, yeah, I don't know what that is.
I don't know. Worse.
Much worse.
No, it's not.
Actually, yes. That is better. Of course. Boom. Perfect. All good.
Well, I just need a new plan. What do you know? You can borrow one of my plans. It's fresh. Never been used. It's called waiting where the sign says to wait. You're stronger than I remember.
Dude.
Look, I know you think I'm being mean, but we're here because of you. If you just do everything you're supposed to do, you'll eventually end up where you need to be.
All around the car, right? Maybe one of the portals will lead us inside the tower.
Maybe that one over there?
Ryan,
can you just let me try something, Min? Without commentary?
Seriously. I mean, there's a chance this might actually work. I'm not even gonna lie.
1 minute, 37 seconds later.
Oh, man. Jeez.
We're here for you, Ryan.
Okay. My guy almost died.
Thanks. How many times do you have to fail to learn the same lesson?
Look,
Dude.
I'm stuck on this train because you're too stupid to even learn the most basic lesson.
I'm sorry, okay?
No, you're not. You say the word, but you don't change.
Really?
People change. What's super helpful? Having someone needle you over every little thing you do.
You're right.
Yeah.
If you would have just listened to me to begin with, we could have just... Whoa.
They're all dead. Oh my god. If he had listened to you, y'all would have been waiting in a line of dead people that would have never moved. What the hell?
They're all dead?
Oh yeah, sure, Mingi.
So, waiting didn't work.
No.
You can mess up even if you stand still.
Yeah. Oh, look.
It's line number two.
Yeah.
Ryan, I...
Save it.
Let's just get out of here.
Dude! Yeah. And right back.
Are no-go. Tunnels are a no-go.
And that bouncer clearly doesn't think we're cool enough for the party.
Doesn't think we're cool enough to attend the party. We are in a band.
Yeah?
Maybe? We can try.
Come on. Look, your plan clearly wasn't finna working if he's the main one coming up with ideas, alright? Let's go. We gotta try something.
What follows is a brief construction montage. We hope you enjoyed this brief construction montage.
Hey, sorry we're late. We got stuck on a meteor. You know
mustache and yeah, spiky right. Mohawk. Okay, works.
Oh my goodness, it's Chicken Choice Judy!
What the Chicken Choice Judy, you mother... These guys, I forgot, that's... Oh no. Don't sit too far. Yes! Oh! Green light!
That could have gone way worse. What? Why did everything just... Until? Where does that line going? Oh no. Oh no. Hey, that's where. Oh no. Oh man. Shit. This is a. That's a bad sign. That's a bad sign.
Wow.
Well, that's not good. This episode is something else. So we're picking up immediately where we left off, because Minky is trying to quote-unquote encourage Ryan, but he's also got this smug-ass look. Like, he very clearly thinks he's better than Ryan in this situation, because he still thinks that this number is only because of Ryan, and he still hasn't realized yet, like, dude, the only reason y'all are here is because of both of you. You both have this number on your hand. And the entire time, he's thinking he knows what's best for the situation. He sees this thing saying, line starts here. I feel like you should have realized this line goes all over the place. Clearly, this wasn't gonna just pan out if they just waited forever. Like, how... You can guess how long this line has been here. Like, all these people here long enough that they die. Like, if they had taken your plan and fallen for the sign, that could have been y'all, man. But yeah, I'm just gonna skip past that part. But anyway, Ryan is essentially trying to all these ideas in order to get into the club. He's trying to go through a vent. He's trying to dig a tunnel underneath. He's trying all of this stuff, but also he ends up hitting a pipe down here that is full of something sticky that then hardens, and he just cracks through it. Strong boots, very strong boots, but Minky is still insistent that they wait in this line because he still thinks that he knows best, because he still thinks that this is only about Ryan and not about him, because he somehow thinks that, I guess, that his idea of waiting in the, or just working in that Humpty Dumpty themed restaurant and staying there for a long time was going to just be the move. And Ryan, he's honestly just fed up with Minky, because he's this entire time, like, I know he's trying to be helpful, but all he's doing is being condescending, because he somehow thinks that he's better in this situation than Ryan, which he's not. Again, y'all both ended up here. You're not just here because of him. Hell, I feel like half of the things that y'all ended up doing were because Ryan pushed you to be more, which, like, on one hand, you don't want to constantly be pressured into something, but on the other hand, like, you can't just wait. You gotta take a step, you gotta take a leap. Life doesn't discriminate between the sinners and the saints. And again, Minky is still mad, because he's still thinking that it's all Ryan's fault and that this happened. And as soon as the number goes back up, he gets even more onto Ryan, until this happens and he bumps into some people. Turns out, yeah, they're dead. And also, that was boned. Oh, gross. Ew. Oh, that's gross. Yeah, they're all dead. They literally waited here so long, they basically just decomposed, and he realizes even if you're waiting in place, you can still mess it up. Like, sometimes it's better to wait things out, but sometimes it's good to jump. Very few ideas and lessons apply to all situations equally. Sometimes you gotta leave, sometimes you gotta make a plan, sometimes you gotta do something, and like, again, oh. And then that part right there was simply just because Minky didn't apologize. Like, dude. Oh, man. They're gonna be on this train for a while. Oh man. But you know what? Ryan, he comes up with another idea. Let's make ourselves cool enough to get in. And then they make these outfits again, the mustache and the spikes, and then Kaz going around controlling a bunch of dead bodies. Oh my god. But yes, the moment they get in here though, things lock up, and to make matters worse, look who decides to show up. We all recognize that tentacle, right? Yep, the last person they want to see. Oh, what's up? Oh, man. So next episode really isn't going to be a party in the party car. On to the next one.
Ryan, don't move. Maybe it'll be worse.
Or
make yourself as big as possible. Show it you're the bigger...
Nope.
This is a train-wide announcement.
What? Came here to... What, give them a guitar? How many people heard that?
Ooh, neat. She left presents this time.
This time?
Yeah, you were like frozen in.
That happens sometimes. But thanks for looking out, Rye Guy.
So all the gnolls get froze. I'm not gonna say. Blah, 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 blah. Get that word out of my mouth. Yuck. So all the denizens of the train just get frozen anytime this happens? Is what you're saying? It wasn't the trunk.
My baby!
Oh, hey, yeah. Oh, nice. Shoot, where's my big
look? No, you were like a dad, but I can see it now.
No, not, no.
Oh, what? No need to be grabby.
Sorry.
Whoa, you brought your mini synth?
Oh, I play with it on my breaks at Dumpy sometimes.
Just carry it around and play?
It's just a toy.
It's not a toy, bro. Come on now. Music.
Party time, corpses.
Oh, right. Now they're in the party. And these are the people that got in, and there's a DJ up there. Wait a minute, what? What? Wait. Fatus?
Medium friends meet best friends. Paco,
why
Brando, Spice Man, Beehive, and Driveway.
Okay.
Hey, Kez, I'm Spice Man. That's Beehive. I mean, isn't
what?
It so obvious?
Yeah, no.
Yeah.
It's like obviously obvious.
So where's Morgan, Kez? Couldn't make it this time, huh?
What's all got against Morgan?
it's Judy.
Ooh, what's up with that hand has arms and hands and legs?
You're so right, Paco. We're always talking about chicken.
So,
what?
Which one of you is the band's bad boy?
Me.
Oh, I don't think either.
Checks out.
Mm.
Well, we haven't played in a bit. Maybe this time you can actually play with me.
I'm not
Ooh.
The only one who needs to get this.
So, Kes forgot to ask. You need anything special for your set?
Permission
oh.
to shred with my main man Min and his mini synth.
Come on, Minky.
Granted, show me the green room.
Yeah, I know where that is.
Kes, that's a bathroom.
There was a bathroom to change it this whole time?
No.
Wait, what? You don't know where...
This is so not the green room. Probably. See, told you she'd get it wrong.
What was I thinking? I was so wrong. That's so funny.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, guys, the actual green room's under the stage. Probably.
I don't like them, and I want that hand to catch these hands. Motherfucking.
No, this is literal.
Green. But purple grapes? Oh, dang, that thing needs to be tuned.
Min, anywhere you put it is good.
Yeah, it's just been a while.
A few moments later.
Wait.
Mm.
I'm gonna dress my dog in a toque. I'm gonna dress my cat in a toque.
Ooh.
I'm gonna dress my dog in a toque.
Ooh.
Dang. Dude, you're like so good. Let's run with something like that on stage.
We Shoot, they don't have anything.
There. Why not?
Why not?
We made it up when we were like six.
So?
Impress them. Impress who? The talking beehive you'll never see again?
True.
Dude, relax. The pressure couldn't be more off.
Hey, so like no pressure, but the pressure is on. Everybody's
Kes!
Like, for you to okay, how much more time do you need? Like 5 seconds?
Give me an hour, bro.
I'm actually feeling pretty ready.
Oh, okay, sure, let's do this. What? What the hell?
So, like, in
a again with these
even a chicken choice, Judy.
All right. Okay, we tuned up.
And this
Men! Oh, men!
Again?
There you have it. Short and sweet.
Are you kidding me? Dude! Oh no.
Oh.
Men, we're leaving. Come on, Kez.
Yeah, you ain't getting out just yet. No.
Yeah, that door doesn't open unless the party's like a success.
Find him! Go find him right now.
Be alone on stage again.
Sorry, I left you out there.
Buddy? Okay, talk. What's up?
I wasn't ready. So, why did you choose to sit in the grossest room at the party?
Kind of feels like home, I guess. Everything's so different here.
Sure.
Yeah.
It's not. Yeah. But what if your shirt didn't fit?
What?
That'd be worse, right?
Wait, you. Of course, because you still kept it.
Never done a show without it.
Of course.
In the wash.
You're also putting it over a jacket, but sure.
We can... Remy, what's the end goal here? Even if we get out of this car, even if we get off this train, even if we become, like, the best musicians in the world?
We're just two Asian guys from BC in a band called Chicken Choice Judy. Can you think of anybody doing what we want to do who look like us?
Oh, damn. Wow, shit, that guy... Heavy?
Behind the Mask is fantastic. Behind the Mask gets all the credit. But the whole album is fantastic.
It is criminally overlooked.
No,
damn.
Just like
that guy. Wow. That got really real.
Guys, the show's back on.
Don't sweat it, Kez. It's so okay.
Lying.
Yeah, we never get our hopes up with you. We can always count on you to fail.
Y'all are dicks! Y'all are dicks! Jeez! Hey, come here. I like that beat. Whoa! Well, shit. Okay. Hey, I like that. Wow. Dang, coming from the last episode into this one, it's just like, damn. Like, I was still thinking about the fact that, like, all the other shit that just happened between them is like, ooh. Man, that took a real turn. Okay. I'm here for it. Mm-hmm. Okay. But anyway, so we first start with apparently everybody just, all the passengers are getting their stuff back, which, you know, again, I say, if we got to get all 8 books, I imagine that there's probably some other people on this train as well, and they probably just randomly got their stuff back too. Like, this feels like it was gonna be meant to do a lot, and I'm really upset the fact that this got canceled, cause like, man, dude. We needed more, but also apparently this happens all the time. But like, all the denizens of the train just get frozen in place, and sometimes random shit happens. And oh no, babe, did you just die? My partner is playing Spider-Man.
I killed and maced me and got this fucking slingshotting off into the sky while dead.
God dang, babe. Okay, but what was I saying? Oh yeah, but apparently just like at random points on the train, like denizens just get randomly frozen in place, but oh well. But we go forward a little bit further,
turns out, huge ass party, and apparently everyone here knows Kez. Kez actually has some friends, or had some friends. Actually, I feel like they're just all a bunch of nameless people, and then the main five we see, they're definitely not her friends. They suck. And then that's where Ryan just gets naked. But also, yeah, seriously, all these guys suck. So, Mr. None of Your Fucking Beeswax, the hot-headed jalapeno stoner owner, this hand who I want to punch in his hand, and the blockhead over there, and then the literal cock. I mean, technically a cock is a rooster. Well, then again, it has those things. So anyway, the point is, these guys suck. They suck. I hate all of them. But anyway, Ryan and Mingy, they are basically going to have to try and figure out a way to, they're going to have to play a concert in order to get out of here. And these assholes really sent Kez on a journey to tell them to go to the green room, which they already knew she didn't know where it was. Like, y'all couldn't tell her this beforehand because you, what, thought it would be funny to see her mess up? Like, again, y'all are dicks. Like, I didn't think I'd actually feel bad for Kez, but like, goddamn. Wow. But yeah, they make their way to the green room, and it is a very green room. Again, so green room, but purple grapes? Not green grapes? What? Y'all did that on purpose. I feel like they did, but yeah, they're over here, they're down here, and they're starting to vibe. They're starting to, like, really feel it again, and they start playing their I want a toque. I want to dress my cat in a toque. Yeah. Yeah, the little song they made up when they were, like, 9 years old, and, like, it's nice to see them actually having fun together and talking together like this. Yes, and, well, they don't have a lot of time to get started, and they're going out on stage, but then as they're about to leave, Mingy pulls these keys to the Humpty Dumpty restaurant out of his pocket, and the look on his face, like, man, it leaves him frozen for a second. At first I thought he actually just left again, and turns out that stage fright clearly got to him, and Ryan, he's pissed and he just wants to get the fuck out of here, but turns out they can't get out of here until the party's pumping. But plot twist, they didn't say what size the party had to be. Like, everybody else left, it was just them, so that party was bumping again, technically speaking. But yeah, Ryan, he goes in here, he just doesn't feel like he's ready or ready for any of this. But Ryan's over here, he's trying to make it better, because of course the Chicken Choice Judy t-shirt, he still had it, he's not gonna stop it. But also, like, you put it over a jacket and another shirt, man, like, I feel like it's more than just the drinking in the wash. But then Mingy says this. I mean, bro, that took a real unexpected turn. Like, goddamn. Right. I feel like they really just hit. I feel like this just again hits at the point of that I always say about representation and why it matters. Because like the fact that this is what's crossing his mind. He can't think of anybody that looks like them that wants to do what they want to do. Like, I mean, but to be fair, you, in order to figure that out, you do have to start somewhere. Somebody has to do it first. So like, I always like to use this example. Like, y'all know my favorite hero is Static. Like, that wouldn't exist without Dwayne McDuffie being the great comic book pioneer that he was, and also just this great letter that he wrote to Marvel about all their fucking characters with that have skateboards, all their black characters that ride skateboards, because Marvel apparently made that an unfortunate weird trend. I'm gonna link that down below, because it's actually really, really funny and elegant the way that he spells the shit out to them all. Like, goddamn. But seriously though, like, you know, he wanted to make comic books that like that he wished he saw grow that he wished he saw or got to read growing up, and he made these characters. He made these characters that spoke to a black, not just a black audience, but everybody that wasn't represented. They made black characters at Milestone. They made Hispanic characters. They made Latino characters. They made Asian characters. Like, they had, like, Milestone was more diverse than both Marvel and DC combined, and even to this day, it kind of still is, especially with Milestone's relaunch. Like, god dang. But, like, the fact that, like, I feel like that's probably what really made Ryan, like, question all of this, because he's, like, questioning, like, can he actually do this, or should he just, like, I don't know, go into this 9-to-5 life, just get a regular job, and just, like, you know, pay bills, do all this stuff. And it's, man, it's, like, god, seriously, I need to, I'm sorry, that just really hits home with me hard, because, like, if I can just give a little real for a second, I went to school for film, and, like, I actually managed to do the thing that every college kid dreams of, and that's get a job in your field, like, right after college. And that's mostly thanks to an alumni that I knew that got me a job on a film set. Like this right here, this was a crew pass that I got when I was working on set as a special effects technician. And, you know, it's, well, after that happened, I got hurt, and I have this scar on my butt because I punched a hole in my hip socket, and I wasn't able to walk for a while, and then the pandemic hit and my entire industry got shut down, and it's kind of still being affected to this day. And, like, I missed a lot of opportunities because of that, and I've been trying to find my way back to that for a while, and it's, I mean part of why I really do love doing this channel is just because I do still get to keep my editing skills up, because I wanted to be an editor more than anything. I like editing videos. I like doing VFX and things like that, and it's just, like, part of why I really wanted to is because I wanted to make a lot of, I was very much inspired by Dwayne McDuffie, and I wanted to make a lot of cool stories and, like, short films and things like that, and I haven't really gotten back to it in a long time. And I mean, I know that people usually say, hey, in order to do it, you just gotta jump to it and do it, but, like, even then, it's like, there's also things involved with that, but also, like, it's kind of hard sometimes, and you just, you're not really sure if you can, get in there and ultimately figure that out. It's just like, it's damn, it's hard. Let's, I mean, on the plus side, like, between all that time, I really started, like, doing a lot more with this channel, and, like, hell, I started doing the Craig of the Creep videos, because I mainly wanted to do that one. I mainly started doing that one because, like, nobody else was doing that show, and I felt like it deserved a lot more love than it was getting. Like, I still say, Craig of the Creek deserves as much love as both Amphibia and the Owl House, and who else? And, like, I look at all the shows, and, like, you look at all the shows I watch. A lot of the different shows I watch are things with, like, diverse cast in many ways, because, like, these are really good shows that I feel like need to be seen more, or... And, like, hell, the show Q-Force, the adult animated show that still gets way too much scrutiny, I honestly would love to work on a show like that. Like, if there was a season two, I have ideas. That show honestly deserves a comeback. Like, I feel like it does, but the main thing I'm saying is, like, with this channel, it's been a way for me to, like, I don't know, keep going in a way. And keep doing the thing I really like to do in certain aspects, then I get to do it in my way. That's part of why I liked doing YouTube in the first place, so. Man, it's a lot. Sorry, I went on a very long rant there. Shit. Wow. Man, the first episode kept me up here, swerving, and now I'm just like, and now I'm going back up. Man, fuck HBO Max. Ugh. Yeah, so, man, but, wow. Like, man, it is really something, but like, but yeah, then as this little bit goes on, like, the kids, like, trying to get them out of the bathroom, and, like, these assholes, they're just like, oh, don't sweat it, kids. We expected you to mess up anyway. It's kind of funny. And it's like, again, these guys are dicks, kids. Like, you messed up a lot, but they're assholes. Man, nah. Also, they asked about Morgan earlier. What's up with Morgan? Shit. Man, but then then Ryan, Mingy opens the door and invites Kaz in to, like, do the thing, and they're just sitting here, they're just playing a little bit of music. It's like they're throwing their own little party, and it's fun. It's a chill thing. Hang, just with friends. Hell yeah. Leaned up against each other. And then notice that their number went down. That was like 75-80 points, man. Damn. Like, shit. Yes, quick math. But shit. Like, that was a huge jump. They made a lot of progress, and they're finally both getting it. That one, they both need to learn lessons, and two, they're actually talking and communicating, which is the real deal thing. Man, Oh, and Dennis, you deserved a lot better. You and this entire crew deserved a lot better. Man, look this. Comment down below, tell me what you think. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll see y'all later. Like, goodbye. Man.